And now we will learn how to change accounting systems for a company that has merchandise inventory. Inventory is an asset. It represents the total purchase cost of all merchandise currently on hand available for sale. Inventory usually goes up when we purchase merchandise, and it usually goes down when we sell merchandise. Inventory is another peripheral area of data that has its own subsidiary set of records, where the total of those records have to match the balance in the general ledger for the T account inventory. Before setting up cost and quantity for inventory, it is assumed that the inventory module is active in the software that you're transferring over to. It's also assumed that the inventory related accounts are already in the chart of accounts, and the inventory items are already on the items list. So you can learn all about these things in the complete inventory course right here on this very website. So how do we set up cost and quantity? Well, we make something called an inventory adjustment. Now, inventory normally changes quantities as well as account balances when we buy or sell merchandise. That would be the normal way. However, an inventory adjustment changes quantities and the ledger account balances without recording a purchase or a sale, which is the normal way it would change. It's usually reserved for rare situations that change inventory without buying or selling. For example, theft, spoilage, catastrophe, those would be the things that would normally change with an inventory adjustment. So what physically happens in the records when we make an inventory adjustment? Well, the quantities on hand and the cost of the items are directly input into the computer in one specific window without recording purchases or sales. The T account inventory balances changes as a result of the new quantity in the subsidiary inventory records. Always, there will be another account that changes with the T account inventory if you make an inventory adjustment. For example, if the reason why you are decreasing inventory in an adjustment is because of theft, then the other account would be something like theft expense, and that would lower your profit and loss, and theft expense would go on the profit and loss report as an expense. If you're adjusting inventory because of a casualty loss, then inventory would go down, and the account that would go up would be an expense account that you would record your casualty losses in and lower your profit and loss and possibly deduct it from your taxes. If you donate inventory, then the related expense that will go up is the expense in your chart of accounts for charitable contributions, and so on. Now, when you make an inventory adjustment because you are changing over to an accounting system, then the proper account that changes with the inventory account will always be an equity type of account. It might be the opening balance equity that QuickBooks suggests that you use, or it could be owner's capital, where the opening balance equity would ultimately get close to. So it would be an equity type of account that changes to balance the inventory adjustment. For example, let's imagine in the old system, at the day you switched over, you had 30 apples at $10 each, making $300 worth of apples. And you had 40 bananas at $20 each, making $800 worth of bananas. That means the balance in the T account inventory was $1,100 at the moment that we finished the old system. So, how do we put that in to QuickBooks. I'm going to show you first how you would put that into QuickBooks Desktop, then I will show you how to put that into QuickBooks Online. So this is what the trial balance looked like after the prior areas of setup. Notice the T account inventory isn't even here because we have not put any items yet. Also notice this report, the inventory valuation detail. This is the best one to show you the items, quantity, cost, and total value of each merchandise item that you sell. And again, it's zero. But when we're finished, it will look like this. It will look like 30 apples at $10 each and 40 bananas at $20 each. And then there will be 1,100 in the inventory account. So let's go ahead and do it. From the main menu, click Vendors, Inventory Activities, Adjust Quantity Value on Hand. Now, the adjustment date obviously is the date that you're changing accounting systems. And in our example, that's March 18th of 2017. Okay. Now, all you have to do is choose the item, in this case apples, and we're adjusting it with a positive number. The new quantity is 30. And we have already put in the items list $10 each. That's how QuickBooks knows it's 300, because we did the basic inventory setup by putting in the list items. Same thing with bananas. Bananas, QuickBooks already remembers we put as $20 each. So if we put that we're adding 40 bananas from an adjustment, that means that the total value of the adjustment is 1,100. Now, when we save and close this window, okay, I don't know if you can see it because of the, okay, but anyway, there's a save and new button or a save and close button. Okay, now the most important thing is the account for the adjustment. And of course, because we're changing accounting systems, the equity account called opening balance equity is usually what QuickBooks recommends for the balancing account when you're starting a new system or changing over to a new system. So we click save and close. Now when we look at the trial balance, you can see inventory asset now has a balance of 1,100. And when we look at the subsidiary inventory records, we see what we need to see. 30 apples at $10 each equals 300. 40 bananas at $20 each equals 800. And that's why the balance in the T account inventory is 1,100. Now the trial balance in our online system has different values because we've been using these two systems slightly differently in the earlier videos. But the most important number for this example is that the inventory asset is starting at zero. And if you look at the reports for the subsidiary inventory records, the report has the same name as the desktop version. So we agree that we're starting with zero. Now we want to adjust inventory. Click the plus sign, click adjust quantity for inventory, and you get this window. Now, even though it suggests an inventory expense related account, like inventory was shrinking, and that expense you can deduct from your taxes, if you're setting up, you really should put an equity account to balance it out. And the products we are adjusting are apples, and the new quantity of apples are 30, so we're going to put 30. And the other one that we're adjusting is bananas, and the new quantity is 40, so we're going to put 40. Okay, QuickBooks remembers that it's in the items list that apples cost $10 each and bananas cost $20 each. So now when we click save and close, we can see that the detail of our inventory subsidiary records show we have $300 worth of apples on the day of setup, $800 worth of bananas on the day of setup, and if we look at the trial balance, we can see that the inventory asset account is now $1,100, exactly what it's supposed to be immediately after the inventory setup. Now you may well ask, what if your company has receivables and payables? Well, you must enter the receivables and payables setup first. The inventory quantities will be affected by your accounts receivable and accounts payable setup transactions if you have a merchandise business. After you set up receivables and payables, you simply subtract the difference between the inventory quantities in the old system minus the quantities in the new system that are there after the accounts receivable and accounts payable setup. That will help you find the amounts that you need to adjust the new system and bring the quantities to the correct amounts as of the setup date. For example, let's imagine in the old system, on the day that we transferred, we had 30 apples and 40 bananas. But in the new system, after we set up accounts receivable and accounts payable, we have 10 apples and 10 bananas. So what would we do? We would simply subtract the 30 apples in the old system minus the 10 apples in the new system equals the 20 apples that would be the amount of the adjustment. Same thing with bananas. If there are 40 in the old system and only 10 in the new system after we set up receivables and payables, then we would have to adjust bananas by 30 to make the number match the old system on the day we transfer over. And then the grand finale when we finish is the main setup journal entry, which will now be the numbers on the last day of the old system minus the numbers in the new system after accounts receivable, accounts payable, and after the inventory setup. And those differences would equal the amount of the main setup journal entry.